You're talking to Linkin Park. Who is at the door?
This is Annette and Jönsch from from
Who's
Baden-Baden.
There? We're like, you know, rock band from America.
Okay. It's Bo.
Awesome. Oh, that's nice.
Okay, great.
Then let's talk about the new German word you learned.
Yeah, nice.
Poops.
Yeah, we love it.
I love poops. Except when you do it next to me on the airplane.
Chester, just a quick question. Are we talking to two guys or just you?
Well, there's more than two people inside of my own brain.
Okay, it's going to be a very funny interview. We love.
It's just me and Joe.
It's you and Joe.
Okay.
It's just me and Joe.
That's awesome.
We got a nice echo. Let's talk about your new single, Heavy. It is the first time you've recorded with a female singer. How did that happen?
You know, she just happened to come in, and we were like, hey, you are a chick, you want to sing on the song? She's like, yeah. We're like, cool. She's like, bam, and then bing, and then bang.
Hey, get on the mic!
We actually, Mike was introduced to Kiara a while ago, and they got to get, you know, they just kind of met and had lunch or whatever, and a few months passed, and we had written a song with Justin Tranter and Julia Michaels, and in the process of recording and not recording, but in the process of writing the song, you know, Julia and I would kind of sing the parts that we were thinking of as we were going along. And it was just like the back and forth between the two of us in that process was really cool. And I think that that inspired us to want to work with the female on the song. It felt like it gave it an interesting perspective because, you know, without Kiara on the track, it's literally just it feels like it's just all about me, and which it should be because everything is all about me,
obviously.
If you guys know
obviously.
That.
Obviously. So now did you basically get the taste for it? Are there any other females you guys really want to work with?
You know, it was really honestly like it was very kind of organic. Mm-hmm. It wasn't like we sat down and went, you know, we should have at least one female artist on this record.
You never had one before.
Yeah, I mean, it just happened. It happened to
well,
work out this
we
way.
We never had a male artist either, right?
Yeah, no, we've only had a.
We've done stuff on remixes and stuff like that, but on our albums, that we didn't collaborate with any vocalists.
It just felt like it was the right time and the right situation.
Cool.
Yeah.
We are one of a few lucky people that already had the pleasure to preview your entire album, which will come out May 19th, One More Light.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Congratulations to you guys.
Oh, thanks.
Do you love it or do you love it a lot?
Yeah, it is very different from the Linkin Park music we've gotten used to over the past year. It's very mellow, very relaxed.
Yeah, what's interesting about the process of writing this record was we started off, you know, just talking about what was going on in our lives, and then we kind of start writing songs. Typically, when we write a record, there's like 50 tracks that we already, you know, worked on, and then the band kind of picks the tracks that we like, and of course, there's going to be heavy guitar-driven tracks that we all like, because that's awesome, right? Right? And so, but when you're working that way, it's like if you have a riff-driven, aggressive, you know, really heavy track, like that's the vocal you're going to get, you know? And it doesn't, it, regardless of whatever I'm feeling or whatever I'm going through that day, like if I'm like, if I just found out that, you know, one of my friends is dying of cancer and I come in that day and, you know, we've got a hardcore punk rock song with like killer, you know, beats on it, I'm just going to put that feeling that I have about my friend to the side and I'm going to write whatever I feel is appropriate that I feel like the song wants me to write about. This way around, it's like if I, you know, it's the opposite. If I come in and I found out my friend is dying of cancer and I want to write about it, I'm going to write about it. And it's going to be more somber. It's going to be more emotional. And then we built the track around that feeling. Mm-hmm. And that's what we did with this record. And I think that's why it feels different than the other album.
But you guys basically just flipped around the working process and tried something new. And one definitely feels that. And also you're kind of sing screaming that we were so used to. It's not really taking place anymore on your current album. Do you think your fans are going to walk that path, you know, that pop music lane down with you guys? Or do you even think your latest work will be met with some sort of resistance by the hardcore Linkin Park fans?
Every song we've ever released has been met with resistance. by somebody.
Yes.
Regardless of the style. So we're used to that. But I mean, honestly, like if you look at the numbers on the track, I think it's like on Spotify, we're like number two right now, or like on, you know, we're really high on the charts. Right. Millions of people are listening to the song. Millions of people have watched the videos and the lyric videos. I think that the track is actually resonating really well with not only Linkin Park fans, but people who aren't fans of Linkin Park or haven't been, or maybe they're just now getting on board because, you know, they don't want to be screamed at the whole time.
Who does? Only if it's by you, Chester.
Okay, let's
listen to what the song is about and then make your judgment. Don't base it on expectations. Mm-hmm.
Okay, then let's talk about the time when you're not at home. Let's talk a little private. Not on tour. What does a regular morning look like in your household?
Oh my gosh. Okay, so here's my day.
Come on, take us with yes.
Okay, I wake up to the sound of 5-year-old girls.
Ooh, nice.
Which is really awesome.
Yeah, awesome.
Typically, we have 6 dogs. So there's a bunch of snoring and farting. And there's all of a sudden I hear the pitter patter of all these feet, you know, running down into the room. And then my corgi named Lady, she jumps on my bed and then attacks my face with her nose and kung. And I'm like, hello, good morning. And I get up and we have to feed the chickens. The chickens are usually going outside. So that's going on. There's a lot of this happening. Okay. Have you brushed your teeth? I told you to brush your teeth 10 minutes ago. We have to do your hair. Put your socks on. No, you have to wear shoes. No, hey, guys, eat your breakfast. We have to leave in 10 minutes. What do you mean you don't know where your backpack is? Are you serious? Like, how do you not know where your backpack is?
So
you
there's a crossover kindergarten / zoo going on at your house.
Yeah, and it's like, awesome. It's like, oh my gosh, like really? Like, ah. Oh. Yeah, that's what my morning's like.
So, I read that you're pretty strict within your household. I mean, you need clear rules with so many kids running around, a lot of animals, of course. Can you elaborate on your strict rules that you have?
Yeah,
in
you
want
to know what my rules are?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No laughing.
Okay.
Oh.
No smiling.
All right.
Okay. No having any fun.
Okay, and no feeling good, right?
Of course not.
No feeling
if you're
good.
Laughing, if you're feeling good, you're going to smile and you're going to
exactly.
laugh and you're going to have fun.
You don't want that.
Okay.
No.
Yeah. And you know what my kids do?
Tell us.
They start laughing and smiling and having fun and like, we're breaking the rules. And it's just like, okay, that's not working. You know what I mean? But, yeah.
Okay. Then let's talk about your son. Just completed building the Lego Millennium Falcon. How often did you step into Lego pieces that were laying around in the early morning?
There are Legos everywhere in my house. Like, it's like Legos, Barbies, which means if you have Barbies, you've got like the little high-heeled shoes. Those suck even worse. Stepping on those sucks worse than like a Lego. But here's the impressive thing. I made it a very interesting task to put together Lego stuff with my kids. So we always separate all the parts out,
okay.
Which takes like a whole day.
Mm-hmm.
So it used to drive my kids crazy because I was like, hey guys, there's always going to be one piece that you just need to find in the midst of 1,000 pieces, right? Like just separate everything out. And that way, when you're going through the instructions, you can just find the pieces you need. So my son Tyler did that, and he built the Millennium Falcon in like an afternoon.
Wow.
Yeah. And so I was like, whoa, it's like 1,400 pieces or something.
Right.
And then yesterday he's like, yeah, check out what I made. You know, it's just a TIE fighter, you know, and he's like holding this huge TIE fighter up. And I'm like, how long did that take? He's like, 2 hours.
Yeah, so. Wow. You yourself, you're a crazy gamer. I read that you like to play the Pokemon hype, and then you had Clash Royale that you've been playing for 8 hours, like without a break. What's your screen name online, and when do you have time to play?
Okay, if I tell you guys my screen name.
I know.
Come, please.
You're going to be super jealous because it's the best screen name ever.
Shoot, let us know.
It's Darth Chester.
Darth Chester.
Yeah, so if you see Darth Chester on Clash Royale. You know you're about to die.
All your fans are going to come look. They want to be killed by you.
By
you know?
My hand.
By Darth Chester.
That's right. I'm about to unleash dragons and magic and death upon your castle.
Mm.
That's my, you know, I have the Dark Kingdom. Some people like to have happy kingdoms. Not me. I'm like Skeletor. I want My castle's made out of human skulls.
So maybe on a more serious note, what are you scared of in life?
Dark Chester.
Oh, that was serious.
Yeah. What am I scared of?
Yeah.
Losing.
In what sense?
In any sense. I'm ultra competitive. I hate losing. I need to come in first place all the time.
But like generally in life, like are you scared of losing like people around you, or is there anything that you're confronted with every day where you say, I don't want that to happen, I'm scared of that?
Yeah, like my mind. I'm afraid of losing my mind. I have 7 kids.
Listen to the record, man.
What do you believe in?
I believe in nothing. That was from The Big Lebowski.
Okay, perfect. Mehr, mehr, mehr auf swr3.de.